बुले हैं इसकी ये गुल चिता हमारा ब्यूटिफुल सॉन्ग इज़न्ट इट बट आयरोनिकली द ओनली टू डेज वी बॉदर लिसनिंग टू इट इज 26th ऑफ जनवरी दैट इज टुडे एंड 15th ऑफ ऑगस्ट बिकॉज वी आर हैप्पीली प्लेइंग पबजी द रेस्ट ऑफ द ईयर एंड विनर विनर चिकन डिनर इज इंडीड द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल थिंग वी स्ट्राइव फॉर But since today is one of the two glorious days, people talk about things like freedom struggle, the sacrifice of freedom fighters, the British tyranny. But most vividly, people talk about one's duties towards the country, or as we say, serving the country. So what does serving one's country actually mean? Does it mean joining the armies, becoming politicians, or civil servants? Yes, no doubt, these are indeed the highest forms of service to the country. But serving the country also has an altogether different and significant dimension. Mother Teresa once said, if you want to change the world, go home and start loving your family. Because family is not an important thing, it's everything. If you want to do some more good to the country, then start loving yourself. Our life begins the day we understand that we are mortal and our life is in our hands to shape. The thing that matters is not what we are doing, but how we are doing it. Our students should strive to give his all to his studies. A teacher should constantly try to improve his skills. Even the Prime Minister should look for room of improvement. Because no matter how good you get, there's always a room to get better. One major issue that concerns me nowadays is when I see the youth criticizing the problems of the country, the poverty, the overpopulation, unemployment, corruption, and the government itself. I've even heard some of them saying, nothing can happen to this country. Some of you might laugh when I say that even a six-year-old can serve the country in an even more unstinting manner. Because the best way to serve our country is by being a better human being. By helping someone in need, by not bullying your classmates, by treating others the way you want to be treated, by restricting your friend from doing something wrong, like damaging the school's property, especially the windows. Entering the 2020s, this decade is going to be the most important one for most of us, in which we need to hustle hard, making ourselves competent enough to make all these reforms. And we have to do that because in the end, it's our country. And if the country with the largest youth population decides to change, then it will definitely lead the world. Leaving you with a highly renowned but overlooked quote by Mahatma Gandhi, be the change you wish to see in the world. Jai Hind.